Edwin Clark, an Ijaw national leader, says the Southeast region is the most disadvantaged political zone in Nigeria. Clark spoke while addressing stakeholders at the South-South Zonal Conference in Port Harcourt, Rivers State capital, on Friday. The conference, organized by Agape Birthright, funded by the Ancure BRICS in partnership with Savannah Center, was themed Restructuring, Imperative for Sustainable Development, Unity and Security. According to Clark, the presence of five states in the Southeast is a form of injustice when compared to the six states in other geopolitical zones and seven states in the Northwest. He said the Southeast zone has a victim of inequality, resulting in several agitations. Southeast geopolitical zone has five states, while other zones, the South-South, the Southwest, the North-Central, the Northeast, have six states each. In fact, the Northwest has seven states. What injustice against a people, he said. Look at the Northernization policy going on in the country. Appointments are skewed in favor of the North, in total disregard to the feelings of other areas. Key position in the ministries, the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, customs, police, you name it, all are given to Northerners. There are 17 security arms, 14 of them are headed by Northerners, yet one accepts that there shall be national unity. Of course, it will not be possible. There must be a dissatisfaction and agitation. For instance, look at what happened in the Southeast today. Our critical national assets are being attacked almost every day. People are killed, maimed, while one is, gravely against such a method of expressing grievance, the people are pushed to the wall. The Southeast geopolitical zone could rightly be described, as the most disadvantaged. One could not understand why the independent people of Biafra, IPOB, will be, declared as a terrorist organization, while similar organizations in the North have not been declared. Clark said unity has become a scarce commodity in Nigeria. What is your thought on what has been said? He said lack of unity is causing distrust and heightened suspicion in many parts of the country. The PANDEV leader added that Nigeria must adopt restructuring to tackle insecurity and end rising agitations. Unity in this country today is unfortunately a scarce commodity, despite the fact that unity is one of the four cardinal points contained in our country's motto, which is unity and faith, peace and progress, he added. Our nation has never been so disunited as we are today. This is, so much distrust. We suspect one another's next move. No nation can survive with such a level of distrust, and the major cause of disunity in the country today is inequality. You do not expect me to live in unity with someone who is oppressing me and treats me as, though I'm a second-class citizen in my own country. This is unacceptable. There is so much agitation in the country. Fortunately, there is a solution to these issues. An action that can be taken, and the nation will, to a large extent, be at peace, and that is to restructure Nigeria now. What is your thought on this that has been said? What is your own reaction to this that has been said? We have heard Edwin Clark, an Niger national leader, saying that the Southeast region is the most disadvantaged geopolitical zone in Nigeria. According to what he has said in a conference organized by Agape Birthright, funded by the Ancure BRICS in partnership with Savannah Center, the title was Restructuring, Imperative for Sustainable Development, Unity and Security. According to Clark, the presence of five states in the Southeast is a form of injustice when compared to the six states in other geopolitical zones and seven states in the North. According to what we have heard, it is obvious that, we have six states in other geopolitical zones, and we have seven states in the Northwest. whereas we have 5 states in the southeast. This is in form of injustice. What is your thought about this? According to what we have had earlier, we have had the people of the southeast agitating for an additional state called, you know, Aba State. They said they want an additional state to equal with other, you know, geopolitical zones in the state, who has, you know, 6 geopolitical zones that has 5 states. What is your thought about this? We would like you to drop your thoughts and comment on this that has been said. We'd like you to share your own, you know, point of view with us on this. So many times we have had, you know, the southeastern people agitating that they have been, you know, marginalized in Nigeria. It is obvious that they have been marginalized. They said they have not been allowed to, you know, take part in any high or key positions in the ministry. According to what we have had in the news, appointments are skewed in favor of the north, in total disregard of the feelings of other areas. The northern people are the one occupying key positions in the ministry, of which is not supposed to be. The president is practicing what we call, you know, tribalism in the government, and he should not be doing that. Is the president, he should, you know, accommodate everybody from different parts. According to the news, appointments are skewed in favor of the north alone, because the, you know, president is from there, in total disregard to the feelings of other, you know, areas. Key positions in the ministries: the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, Customs, Police. You just continue to name, you know, key positions in the ministry, then you see that the leader or the head of these key positions are from northern parts. Why is this happening? We have 17 security arms and 14 of them are headed by the north. Why is this happening? Is it that it is only the north that are qualified for this post? Why are they always giving it to the north? These people are agitating for what they think is the best way to go about this, because they feel they have been cheated, they feel they have been marginalized. Well, it is obvious that what the president is doing, what he's practicing, is not acceptable as the president of the country. You should not be, you know, practicing tribalism. You should not be discriminating one region, you know, for another. What is your thought about this? There are 17 security arms and 14 of them is headed, you know, by northerners. Then the 3 remaining, who is heading it? What is your thought about what has been said? There must be dissatisfaction and agitation because of what is going on presently. What do you think can be done in this kind of situation? What do you think can be done to be able to curb the present situation of things in Nigeria? According to the news, there is so much agitation in the country, and it is obvious. Fortunately, there is a solution to these issues. Then we are looking for the solution. According to the news, there is a solution, an action that can be taken, and the nation will, you know, to a large extent be at peace. And that is to restructure Nigeria. Now, we have been told to restructure Nigeria because that is the best way to go about the present situation and to provide a lasting solution to the, you know, situation at hand. And to a large extent, Nigeria will be at peace, because restructuring is the answer to all these questions of insecurity, all these questions of, you know, inequality that has become the order of the day, that has become the challenge against Nigeria. What is your thought about this? We would like you to drop your thoughts and comment on what has been said. Thank you guys for listening. Do subscribe to this channel if you have not, and I'll see you on the other news. Bye for now.